Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I hope you liked my previous videos. Today we are going to talk about pie charts, how to create pie charts in datastudio. As we know, pie chart is a circular disk format in which we try to present the share of the attributes in percentages or in values. As we can see on our screens that in this pie chart, consumer products have 92.6% of share. And if I talk about construction, it is 4.6. If I talk about IT sector, it is 2.3, and in automobiles, it is 0.5. Today we are going to replicate this chart and see what all features and options are present in datastudio. So to create the pie chart, we have to go to the insert on the top, click on pie chart, click it again on the sheet. It will give you some data here. Now, as you can see, there is stock name here, right? So if I want to replicate this particular pie chart is based on industry type. So instead of stock name, I'm going to put industry here. I'll just search industry on the top right. I'll just drag and drop the industry over the stock name. Here it is. We have stocks. Industry types here. Now we have metrics in here. So instead of metrics, I want revenue. I just want to see the revenue share. I will just search revenue. I'll just drag and drop the total revenue over the record count. Once I have the revenue here, now see my data is populating here as of now. We have the industry types as well as the revenue percentage. We can see that the percentage is also matching. Now the point is, which type of pie chart you like, this one or this one? Obviously we have borders in here, we have different colors, so we'll try to format this pie chart as per this. So for the first thing, if I talk about color coding, right? So we have to go to the style section in here. I'll click on style. As I can see, we have number of slices option in here. How many slices do you want? For example, there are 20 industry types. So I'll just go and click on 20. Just make sure, for example, if any column, like for example, in industry, if it has 20 types of industries and you have selected six, it will only show the top six. Okay. So make sure that what is the unique count of that particular column. So in this case, I only have four industries. So that's why I'm selecting four. It is as it is. Now we have option of color type. What type of color I want? In some people like single color like this, the shades of one particular color. Okay. And the second is slice. It will give different type of colors. And I also can change the color. So if I want it to convert into gray, this particular portion, I've clicked on it. It will turn to gray. See, this is now gray. If I want to convert it into blue, I can just click on the blue section and I can change the colors accordingly, according to my requirement. So it is little bit slow. I have already selected blue color here. So I believe it will come. Yeah, it has. So finally, I've selected the color, everything is fine, but I want this particular index, right? This was the list of, you can say the list of industries to be at the bottom. So we'll just go to style. We'll go downstairs and we'll just go to the bottom. We have an option to adjust like this. See, we have different options here, how to convert, how to manage the labels basically, right? I just brought them at the bottom. Now I also want the border, right? The shadow as well. So if I talk about border and shadow, you can go at the bottom. You will see add borders. Okay. Now if I have borders, I already have the borders. Okay. Correct. Cool. So I want the black line as well at the borders, right? I'll just click it again. I'll go to style and where it was written add borders, I'll just try some steps here. I'll just click it on this portion. Okay. So basically the background and border is basically changed by these filters. So we have the black border as well in this. Now we have all the legends at the bottom. We have the color coding with us. Now I want to change this background color to gray. I'll just click it again. Go to style. I'll just come here and I'll just see whether I can change the background. Okay, background, I'll just click on this. I'll just change to this. Okay, cool. I've changed the color. It's pretty dark. I'll just change it again. I'll just go to style. I'll just go here. I'll just lighter it down. Cool. Okay, so now we have this. Now the last step in pie chart, I want this hole, right? This donut shape in pie. So I'll just click it again. I'll go to style and I'll just slide this slider like this. Okay, so basically this decides what will be the diameter of this particular circle. It will give you a donut type of chart. And as we can see that we have replicated the pie chart. So there are multiple options in here. I've walked you through the basic, most basic ones where we can change the color, background, border, the styling of the border. We have the percentages. Now, one more thing, like for example, if I want instead of percentages, I want values, normal values, right? I'll go to label. If I want to change the label, I'll go to this percentage section, I'll go on and select the value. See, the value has been changed. So you can also have none. There will be nothing in here. If you want percentages, you can have percentages. If you want labels, you can have the labels as well. And if you want the value, you can select the value. So you can style your pie chart with the help of this style section in here. And for setups, we discussed that the type of column you want to select, you can select from here, and the type of metric you want to show on the pie chart. So I hope you like this video. This is all about pie chart. Thank you very much.